Well, hello there. Today we're going to talk a little bit about this up here, rebooting. And yeah, we have Windows here because a lot of people like to make fun of Windows rebooting. I'm going to talk to you about why having a long uptime basically is not a good idea. So I made a post, uptime 8 days, 14 hours, 30 minutes and counting. What OS is it? Linux, Mac OS, and Windows. This don't matter. It don't matter how long the uptime is, but it is Windows. I've had Windows running for over 30 days without having a reboot. But why do I say that don't matter? Well, if there is a system update, you need to reboot. You have to reboot. It don't matter what operating system you're on, you need to reboot. Because when you're installing a major update for Windows, Linux, and so on and so on, you're getting a lot of new features. Some of the services are restarting. You know, some of them you can restart yourself, but you could still potentially be running old configs because they, in some instances, are not getting refreshed until you do a hard reboot. So that means that you could have installed the latest version of a service or internal operating system component, but until your hard reboot, you're still running the older version or partial older version. So if there is a security risk, if there's a backdoor and all of that fucking shit, you potentially could still be vulnerable for it. So why do people go into all of this with uptime? Well, that's because they see server OSs. They see Linux on the server, they see Windows on the server, and they run Linux for and Windows for months without rebooting. They don't update that often. And also, the way that they are set up is that Windows Server is not the same as Windows Home Professional or Home Edition. Well, Home Professional. Windows Professional or Windows Home Edition. Red Hat, the way it's set up on a server, is not the same as the Red Hat that you've set up at your home machine. SUSE, Ubuntu on a server is not set up as your machine at home. They don't have a lot of the same fluff or plot or shit installed that you use. Most of them don't even have a fucking desktop manager installed or a Windows manager installed. So there's a lot of caveats to that. And the way they do updates is also a little bit different than we are, well, how we are doing it. And they do reboot when it's necessary. So if you are an OpenSUSE user and you go in and you do an update, no matter if it's sleep or tumbleweed, if you look at the command line, it says to you, some services has been updated, a reboot is recommended. Why is it saying that? That's because, like I said before, there are certain things that will only go into effect after a reboot. So how do you potentially do that on a server side? Well, let's say it's the this is just hypothetical, this is not like a real use case or real case, but it's to get you an idea. Let's say there's a bunch of updates over a month. The only one that require a reboot could be, let's say, the firmware for your network card in your machines, and you look at that, what it's fixing. It's really just updating the firmware, maybe getting a little bit of feature, maybe fixing some things that you don't have an issue with, but it's not a security issue, it's not anything like that. You don't need to update it. You know, it's like one of those nice to have features. So you can potentially say, okay, I'm updating everything else that don't require a reboot, but I'm not updating, let's say, the firmware from a network card. Again, you could just restart your network card without restarting your computer. I know that they don't just go in and do sudo apt update, sudo apt upgrade a lot of times. They have tailor-made update path. In Windows, a lot of time, they update one computer and then via Azure, they update everything else on the network. So they download it once and then deploy it anywhere else. And Linux can do the same. And then you can tailor-made those updates so you only are getting the updates that you actually need. When I see people having massive long uptime, I get a little bit concerned because I'm sitting here and thinking, how many updates have you installed where you potentially could be insecure because you have not rebooted? So you're not taking full effect of those updates. You need to do a hard reboot. And I can't sit here and tell you 100% precisely what they are with each operating system, because it depends. It also depends what kind of, you know, is it a feature update or is it a security update and blah, 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 blah. My rule of thumb here is I do it under Linux, I do it under Windows. Every time I do an update under Linux, I do a reboot. Every time I do an update under Windows, well, it asked me to do a reboot, but I do a reboot. Every time I do an update on the Mac OS, the times I ran Mac OS, even though it also tells me to do a reboot, I 9 out of 10 times do a reboot on those systems. There will be cases where I don't reboot right away because I have to do some work and stuff like that. And then I reboot later. Just to make sure that I'm not sitting here in this false sense of security and thinking, ah, I just updated my system, but then in reality, Some component of my system can only be updated or refreshed after a hard reset. As a consumer that are running things way differently than they do in the corporate and server market, you have different requirements. And I don't know how I can spank this into the anuses of the computing world, but people, they tend to sit on their Windows machine and their Linux machines and then look at, you know, Red Hat's whatever version on a server, or Debian stable on a server, or Windows server, and say, oh, well, that can do that, so my system should be doing that. No, they are totally different operating systems in the way that they are set up. See you all later. Bye-bye.